Today I am going to tell you about income and expenditure account, which is prepared by non-for-profit making organization as their financial statement. First, income and expenditure account is a nominal account, and the rule of nominal account: debit on expenses or losses and credit on incomes or gains are followed here. It has two sides, debit side and credit side. Debit side is expenditure side and credit side is income side. We record only revenue items in income and expenditure account. All revenue expenses at the debit side and revenue incomes at the credit side. The main and popular revenue for non-profit making organization is subscription. So put here by subscriptions. As per receipts and payments account, receipts and payments account, then subscription outstanding at the end of the year will be added here, plus outstanding subscription at the end and advance subscription at the beginning will be also added here, plus advance subscription at the beginning added. Then we will deduct from here outstanding subscription at the beginning. Then we will deduct from here advance subscription at the end. Now amount will be placed in the main column. In the same way, at the expenditure side we will put like rent as per receipts and payments account. We add here outstanding rent at the end. And less outstanding debt at the beginning. Then amount will be placed in the main column, like insurance as per receipts and payments account put here. And if there is prepaid, we will add prepaid insurance at the beginning. Then we will place prepaid insurance at the end. Then balance will be placed in the main column. The next item of revenue income by entrance fees put here, by general donation put here, by sale of old newspaper put here, by sale of grass, by interest on इन्वेस्टमेंट बाय रेट ऑफ ऑन रेट ऑफ ऑन एटसेट्रा दिस आर रेवेन्यू इनकम्स एंड will be placed at the credit side of income and expenditure account. Now some revenue expenses which are to be debited to income and expenditure account like salaries, like postage, like depreciation on fixed assets, like loss on sale of fixed asset. If there is gain on sale of fixed asset, it will be placed at the credit side by profit on sale of fixed asset. Students, we should remember one thing: the preparation of income and expenditure account is little complex as compared to preparation of receipts and payments account, because under income and expenditure account we record only revenue incomes and revenue expenses. Second thing that is very important is we record only those revenue incomes at the credit side of income and expenditure account that is related to current year, means previous year's and next year's revenue income will be excluded from here. In the same way, at the expenditure side of income and expenditure account, we record only those revenue expenses which are related with current year, means previous year's and next year's revenue expenses are excluded from here. After posting all revenue incomes and all revenue expenses, we close the income and expenditure account by comparing which side is exceeding. If credit side is exceeding the debit side, then we will add it first, then place the total at debit side, and balancing figure will be to excess of income over expenditure. It is also known as surplus, and it will be added to capital fund at the liability side of closing balance sheet. Suppose if debit side is exceeding the credit side, then we will add debit side first and put that total here, credit side, and balance here it will be by excess of expenditure over income, and it is also known as deficit balance, and it will be deducted from capital fund at the liability side of closing balance sheet. So students, preparation of income and expenditure account is very simple. We have to pick only revenue items, revenue expenses at the debit side, and revenue incomes at the credit side. In subscription or in expenditure side, we adjust all the adjustments. Adjustments like outstanding and prepaid or advance. Here, subscription as a receivable payment account, we added two items: outstanding subscription at the end because it belongs to current year, advance subscription at the beginning means subscription received in advance in the last year, it belongs to current year, that's why we have added it here. And we deduct two items which is not related with current year, like outstanding subscription at the beginning of the year means at the end of last year, it belongs to previous year, that's why we have deducted it. And advance subscription at the end of the current year means it is related with next year, that's why we have deducted it. Thank you.